I'm just waiting. One second. Also, while I open my drink. To make sure that I'm live. Some of you, Kim, I know you in particular, are like, it's about time. You guys, I literally just finished recording my last video and sending it to my editor guy, and I'm in a really funny place in my kitchen because there is such bright light coming in from sunny Texas. I had to adjust the camera here, that I had to like put my tripod over here. There's also some strange noises going on outside. Anyway, happy Monday. I am so excited to chat with you guys, and I also need my bangs cut. But it really just wouldn't be a Kelly Olexa video if I wasn't futzing with my hair in some way. So anyway, happy Monday. Many of you guys are probably gonna watch this on the replay, so either happy Monday or Tuesday, whenever you watch this. I am back from Phoenix. I had a wonderful weekend, and I am so fired up, and I made sure to give myself a couple of notes to go by so that I get right. As I realize, I haven't gotten right to the point. So I get right to my points, and I go in an order that makes sense for all of you. Because what I was referring to earlier is I've had, particularly in the past couple of weeks, just like in succession, several massive awakening, aha moments. And by the way, if any of you join me live, I think in the future, I'm gonna stick to doing live videos when I announce it and I know people can be there, because what's disturbing about when there isn't anybody to attend and I'm doing a live video, I don't know if it's actually coming through. Maybe I should check. I can do that on my other phone to see if I'm actually live in the group, but it actually might not let me log in here, so hold on. I'm gonna do it and see if I'm live on here. Okay, I think I'm live. Anyway, I've had a succession of all of these aha moments about weight loss, really. Weight loss and then a bigger picture about health. And I'm gonna talk about what I learned this week about cleansing and tying that back to fasting and so on and so forth. Because of course, none of us are looking to just strictly lose fat, strictly lose weight. We want to be healthy. We want to make this long-term. This is also about wellness and longevity. And so I'm going to share with you guys everything that has been so overwhelmingly like the coolest. I just can't even describe to you how the past 2 weeks, everything that I've learned in succession, many of which are lessons or things that I've heard before, but the way that I've heard it, the timing that I've heard it, and how I'm putting everything together, combining with me being able to be real with myself and go, okay, this is what I haven't been doing. This is why I haven't been having the results I wanted. I am literally so fired up to be heading into the holiday season. And you guys, I'd be saying this same thing to you. I want to let you know, I would be saying this same thing to you all in this group and really to anybody that knows me. I would be saying the same thing to you if this was April. It just so happens that it's the holiday season. And what I'm sharing with you is that I'm so fired up to start implementing what I've learned in a big way. And for the first time in several years, I have the utmost certainty that I will reach my goals, reach the ultimate weight loss goal that I've been trying to hit for several years. And I feel great about it. And I also feel great about it considering it's the holiday season, you know? I mean, this is the time of year when people typically go to one extreme or the other. They're either gonna go and look at the holidays and go, oh, I'm gonna be at, you know, this Thanksgiving event, I'm gonna be seeing family and friends I haven't seen in forever. I'm gonna do some crash diet or go keto so that I can, you know, lose all this fat fast and impress people. Or they're gonna be the other mindset. They get to this time of year and they're like, I haven't reached my fat loss goal again. I feel gross in all my clothes. Screw it. It's the holidays. I'm not going to diet through the holidays. Screw this. I'm just going to enjoy the holidays and I'll start fresh in January. That's when everyone's depressed. That's when everyone's joining the gym. Screw this. I'm just going to, and then they go balls to the wall with, you know, eating all the things and not working out. And then what happens is they create this environment in January where they feel more loathsome about themselves. Yada, yada, yada. What I'm sharing with you is, for the first time, I'm heading into the holidays. No, I'm not happy with where I'm at. I distinctly remember how I felt last year at this time. I had been working with a dietitian that, to say she derailed my fat loss efforts is an understatement. I was thicker, heavier. None of my clothes fit me. I remember we were going home to Houston to visit Steve's family, and I didn't want anybody to see me. Hey, Shannon. And it was the worst feeling ever. So am I in that state now? No. But am I at my fat loss goal? No. But I'm here the week before Thanksgiving knowing, thank you, Shannon, I appreciate that, knowing that I can go into the holiday season, enjoy the wine, enjoy the turkey, enjoy the stuffing, enjoy the Christmas parties in December, enjoy New Year's Eve. We're gonna be traveling back to Chicago. We're gonna be going to Miami after that. I'm gonna be able to enjoy the treats and indulgences over the holidays, but also get my workouts in and stick to applying what I've learned with caloric deficit and the cleansing and the fasting that I'm gonna share with you. And I truly believe that I'm going to be sharing with you the first week of January, and I don't know what it is. Maybe it'll be 5 pounds. Maybe it'll be 2 inches. Maybe it'll be 10 pounds. I don't know. I will be losing weight and making progress through the holidays. And I firmly believe that within 90 days, I mean, I'm not saying I have to. My ultimate goal is to lose. I probably to be at my ideal fat percentage, I think I probably would be comfortable losing about 20 pounds. So I think that within 90 days, I will reach that. And I have not been able to confidently say that in several years. And it's because I've been feeling like, I just can't fix my hypothyroidism. I'm stuck with Hashimoto's. It's, you know, a year or so ago, I had adrenal burnout. So that was in effect for a while. And then I was listening to a dietitian's advice that was totally wrong. And then I was eating healthy, but not applying a caloric deficit, unbeknownst to me. I thought I was. Lots of stuff has happened to make me feel cumulatively over the past couple of years. I kind of felt powerless. I kind of felt like maybe I'm stuck. I'm stuck in this perpetually almost there. People think I'm fit, but I'm not really fit. I feel like I'm okay. I feel good in clothes, better with Spanx, not good, not great in a bikini, you know, like I'm just done. And I've been done being at that place, but I have not felt confident that I could get past it. And I never blamed my age. I've just been blaming hypothyroidism. So what I'm going to do is go into what these crazy, wonderful aha moments and lessons that I've been exposed to over the past 2 weeks that have put me in this position where I'm like, bam, here's the deal. It's on. Any of you that want to go with me, you can do it too, because I just know. I know that I was exposed to all of this information to make me go, what? So that I can do this for myself, but also so I can take a lot of you with me, because I know so many of you in this group, and I'm also gonna take this recording and make this into a podcast and make it public later. And I can't tell you how many messages I get, and people that have been following me for years or people that just discover me now. I've got women in their late 20s that have hormone issues. I've got women in their 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s. Everybody's got the same problem. They're all like, I'm stuck. I can't lose weight no matter what I do, blah, 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 blah. There are some basics that everyone's missing. And if you apply I really firmly believe we can all optimize our health. lose fat, and get in a much better place where we don't feel like we're constantly swimming upstream and that nothing's gonna work and that we're gonna be like complaining and whining and frustrating. We can do this. I'm gonna do it, and I sincerely challenge all of you to join me in whatever way that looks like, you know, join me as officially as you want to or not. So here's where things started for me. A lot of you guys know I've shared it in here. I've shared it on my social media, my Instagram, yada, yada, yada. One of the first things that just was this mind-blowing lesson for me recently was stumbling on this guy on Instagram, Jordan Syatt. He is going to be interviewed on my podcast. I hope all of you are subscribed to The Kelly O Show. Hard plug, not ashamed. He will be on the podcast, I think in January. He was supposed to be in November, but understandably we had to move it. I stumbled on him. I really don't know how. I think it was another podcast guest. And I started looking at his posts, and then I went and I watched some of his YouTube videos. Strongly recommend that you ladies go dive into his YouTube videos. If you're okay with some language, hopefully you are, because I swear a lot. You know, he is probably, I think, the best thing out there, one of the best things out there in fitness, because what he is teaching will snap you out of crazy mindsets that are not your fault. You've been exposed to messaging from the media, from Instagram, from Facebook, from Pinterest. I mean, I saw stuff on Pinterest the other day about like, here's how to target fat underneath your arms. Do these exercises, it'll burn fat under your arms. You can't spot target fat burning, dumbasses. Okay, I'm digressing, but I get very upset when I know that people are being misled by this stuff. Oh, you wanna lose weight? Just go keto. Really? Anyway, so, and nothing against, I do know some people that are, they live the keto lifestyle. It's just that the people that I know that are successfully living the keto lifestyle, the vast majority of them did it for health and for like gut issues. They didn't do it for weight loss. When I see people going, I'm gonna lose weight, I'm gonna buy a Peloton and go keto, I'm just like, okay, welcome to like 700 pound weight gain in about 2 months, okay, when you rebound. I digress. So, stumbled on Jordan Syatt. He had a video, actually he had a podcast interview with a woman who has Hashimoto's, which is what I have, which is what a lot of you have. And he interviewed her in an hour-long podcast, and it so struck home to me because here was this woman who was saying all the things that I've been saying for the past couple of years. She's like, I've purified my diet, I've added all the supplements, I've read all the books for Hashimoto's hypothyroidism, I've done this, I've done that, and no matter what I do, I can't lose weight, I can't lose fat. And she said, it wasn't until I, you know, joined your program, Jordan, joined your inner circle, I think that's the name of his program, that she started to lose weight. Hey, Tracy. And so I'm listening to this podcast going, that's been me. And essentially what she was saying is, what she thought she couldn't lose weight. She was eating all organic paleo. Again, I'm summarizing so I could be misspeaking on some of these points. Organic, non-GMO, not processed foods, cutting out alcohol, watching for carbs, cut, you know, all these food rules that we've all been exposed to, right? She's doing all of that and not losing any weight, staying the same weight. That's been me for the longest time. I've just been staying the same weight. And then on top of that, this year, a lot of you guys know, you know, I was sidelined and probably lost 80% of my workout time for the past 4 to 6 months due to chronic migraines, chronic headaches, just ridiculous. So I listened to that podcast and I was like, what? Because once that woman who had the highest level of skepticism, when this Jordan guy told her, you need to be in a caloric deficit, and she gave him the answer that I've said to several trainers over the past years, I know what I'm eating. I'm totally fine. My diet's fine. It's not my diet. And most of you, let me tell you, if you would put a camera, retroactively speaking, and follow me around for the past 2 years, nobody would say, Kelly Olexa is full of it. I've seen her eat. Now, number one, I love to eat, okay? I have an appetite. I love to eat. I can eat a dozen Krispy Kreme donuts and probably still be hungry 3 hours later. I'm not that girl who's like eating a few leaves of lettuce and I'm full. So I can eat, but I also, if you would have retroactively placed a camera and followed me around, you would probably look at me, and most people would probably look at me and go, how can that girl eat the stuff she eats? And if she's saying she can't lose weight, nobody can lose weight. That's what a lot of people would say about me, because you would see me eating egg white omelets. You would see me eating, you know, my coffee with almond milk and stevia and monk fruit. You would see me making turkey meatloaf. You would see me eating organic, paleo, blah, 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 blah. Hi, Barb. And so if you watched me the past several years, you'd be like, Kelly Alexa's eating healthy. And nobody would say, oh, I've seen her binge. I've seen her secretly doing this, that, the other. No. So I thought I was spot on with my eating. I thought I was fine. I also thought that I knew what caloric window I was in. I thought I knew how much I was eating every day. I really thought that my problem was that quite often when I work, I will not eat enough. And that certainly has been a challenge for me in many years where, you know, I can come out and I'm unintentionally fasting all day because I've had my coffee in the morning, I get really busy, and it's kind of weird because as somebody who loves to eat, it's very easy for me to not eat all day. But listen to that podcast. He's interviewing this woman with Hashimoto's who's saying she did all the things. People, I've read every book on Hashimoto's hypothyroidism there is. I've read every book on adrenal fatigue there is. I've read every book on PCOS. My brain is so full with information on hormonal imbalance and what to take, and I can tell you all of these different experts and ebooks that I've bought, and I applied all of it, and I'm taking selenium, and I'm taking iron, and I'm taking vitamin D3, and blah, all these, you know, spending $700, $800 a month on supplements, plus bioidentical hormonal replacement treatment. Now, a lot of that stuff is doing well. But this woman was doing the same thing, and it wasn't until she got very strict and started writing down every single thing she was eating and making sure that she was in her caloric deficit window that finally, guess what happened? She lost weight. And I do encourage you, if you haven't, go look up Jordan Syatt's podcast and look up, there's two interviews, one with a woman recently, I think she has PCOS, and then another woman who, it's the Hashimoto's hypothyroidism, how to lose weight with it. And then he has another recent episode, strictly more on a woman with binge eating and up and down. That's just another good episode. But he's a gold mine. So this was the thing that set me off on the, oh my God. Because the truth is, ladies, this fitness girl, this one who knows it all, right? Once I started paying attention to what I was eating and all the extra little nibbles of, oh, well, I can have a few extra of these peanut butter balls I made for my man. I mean, it's organic honey, organic peanut butter, organic dark chocolate, organic oats. It's oats, which is carbs, dark chocolate, which is sugar, honey, which is sugar, peanut butter, which is sugar and fat. And each ball, once I went and figured out the macros for the balls that I was making, each one is about 110 calories. So when he and I would sit down to watch Netflix and chill, I realize I should qualify that because I think Netflix and chill means something very dirty. I'm saying we sat down and watched TV. But when we would bring out those peanut butter balls that I would make, he and I could easily eat six or seven of those. They're these little delicious balls. And you don't think about that because when you have that mindset of, you know, well, this is healthy. This is, or if I was cooking dinner at night and I was, you know, making something for him when he was in a trial, he got home really late at night, I'd probably already had my three meals. But my stomach's a little, you know, little not full. And I'm making him some, you know, I remember distinctly one night, I was making him some grilled chicken with vegetables, zucchini on the grill, the inside grill with black beans and rice. And I'm like, I'll sit down and have this with him. You know, old school Kelly, know-it-all Kelly, fitness Kelly would go, this is grilled chicken, organic grass-fed non-GMO chicken, this is organic black beans, this is brown rice, this is avocado, it's healthy fats, this is, you know, everything on that counter that I was cooking that night was good for me, was healthy. There's nothing wrong with it. But the bottom line is, if you've already eaten to your caloric deficit window and you eat that, that's what keeps you from losing weight.